under his deemed presidium, under his deemed delegates. So is chemoradiotherapy of the lung cancer locally advanced an alternative to surgery? The answer, partial answer, may be seen from these two slides. Based on the ACS for non-small cell lung cancer, third, fourth grade, chemoradiotherapy very often was a preferred therapy, while pure surgery amounted to only 2%. A totally opposite situation in Russia. Official data for 2017 show that the majority of patients received only surgery, while chemoradiotherapy amounts to very low 3%. Based on the statistics, the same as elsewhere in the world, around 30% of patients are detected in grade 3 NIMAGU, and only radiotherapy cannot work on its own. This is my own opinion, what I might have preferred in one clinical situation or other. The first stage of non-small cell lung cancer. After quite optimistic data we received as of lately, the stereotactic radiotherapy or SABR is quite good, and comparable results may be received compared to radical surgery and even lower toxicity. In the beginning of this year, we've heard from Canada, second phase trial, Canadian second phase trial, that SABR provides PCR only in 60% of patients after 10 months after the completion of therapy. Maybe the patients have to be observed dynamically so that the progression should be detected in time. Or maybe SABR is less efficient. Nowadays, at least 8 trials are going in trying to study SABR with the immunotherapy, second and third phase, like Pacific 4. If they will show complete pathological regression, maybe this will impact broader third phase clinical trials. 2B stage is actually the stage when the surgery has to be performed, but we have a different situation if we have a more advanced stage 3B, 3C, where chemoradiotherapy has to prevail, because it's a very subtle differentiation between a truly advanced and advanced process, hence chemoradiotherapy. Besides, we have data that the addition of immunotherapy will allow us to improve the results of treating such patients, even patients, non-operable patients. What is to be done in case of 3A, potentially operable? We have a great diversity within this 3A stage, starting from very small size of primary tumor in mediastinum and ending with a huge local process and signs of regional lymph nodes involvement. Can we perform chemoradiotherapy to such patients and think that the results will be okay, or shall we try to operate them? The situation is as follows. Nobody has proven that one method or other has certain benefits, and there are very few prospective randomized trials. But there is one meta-analysis from Germany, dated 2012. 6 randomized trials have been included. The period is 20 years, not that many patients, because some of the trials were closed, partially due to poor recruitment of patients. And 3 were closed that consecutive chemoradiotherapy in one of the groups was recognized to be inefficient, and simultaneous chemoradiotherapy was applied. That's why the trial was closed. all patients are 3A and 2 stage, different chemotherapy, different combinations with radiotherapy, different dosages, different surgeries. In the two last studies, we see that it impacts survival greatly. But in terms of overall survival, the balance was fluctuating one way or the other, and that's why there was no real evidence in favor of one method or the other. A progression, recurrence-free survival, or progression-free survival, the benefits of the American shown by the American groups was unyielded by the other two studies that showed no difference. As for complications in the surgery group, the risk of death on the background of therapy was much higher than in the conservative group. And this certainly had a negative impact on overall survival. Hence, the main conclusion of this meta-analysis was simultaneous chemo-radial therapy, well-planned and more safe and well-conducted for the potentially resectable NSCLC 3A stage is preferable. Chemotherapy and one local method are preferred. Trimodal therapy doesn't have any benefits in favor compared to chemoradial and chemotherapy plus surgery. This data support the use of chemotherapy and only one local method, as said. This is confirmed by two quite recent studies from Germany and Switzerland, where patients after the three courses of induction therapy either went to surgery or was to chemoradiotherapy and then surgery. In terms of survival, progression-free and overall survival, no difference. But still, coming back to this vicious 3A stage with very diverse statuses, it is quite evident that these tumors have different biological behavior and sometimes the approach has to be different to them. It is thought that T4NO tumor, huge local process, but without any signs of regional lymph nodes involvement, maybe the T4 is more local than systemic, and these patients may do better if they are first operated and then have some chemotherapy. There are some data in favor of this scenario. R0 means around more than 40% of 5 years overall survival, compared to 16% when the status is R1. But what about N0 status? In reality, it may fluctuate from 40 to 45%, but the operation within these situations may be performed only in high-tech centers with the surgeons of great mastership. As for the patients who can't reach these centers because of their health, only chemoradial therapy remains for them. What's to be done in the N2 case? The patients may differ. There are data showing that the volume of lymphonodes involvement is more important than their location. Multizonal involvement is worse. And for the patients with one zone, involvement of mediastinal lymph nodes, surgery may be considered with chemotherapy at neoadjuvant stage or the stage of adjuvant. If there are bulk lymph nodes or commissioned lymph nodes, radiotherapy has to be considered. Conclusions. In locally advanced, potentially resectable non-small lung cancer 3A stage, the adequate chemoradiotherapy is preferred, especially in patients with N2. If we have N2 within one area, N2 up to 3 centimeters, surgery, preferably a lobectomy, is a method of choice. Trimodal therapy with neoadjuvant chemoradiotherapy on first stage doesn't have any benefits, while for the progression of local and systemic therapy, as well as fundamental studies, it will allow us to define the preferred group of patients, the preferred candidates for chemoradiotherapy, will improve the result of all therapy. This slide shows you the optimization of chemoradiotherapy in order to increase its efficiency. Local regional optimization and systemic optimization. There are trials going on in this direction. We are entering personalized medicine and personalized radiotherapy. I think this will help us at some point. To my opinion, personalized chemoradiotherapy means defining the initial sensitivity or resistance of the tumor to irradiation prior to therapy, based on genetic tests, detection of genetic signatures, etc. Second, assess the efficacy of radiation based on objective biomarkers in the process of therapy. And number three, trying to find the predictors of complications. As for the second point, there are very interesting data, for example, liquid biopsy. We talk about it a lot. Circulating tumor cells have prognostic significance, and circulating stromal cells that can be detected at any stage and are associated with tumor invasion. If they are taken from the irradiated focus, they have to have signs of the damage of DNA by irradiation. One of the markers of this irradiation may be RAD50 protein. It was shown that the more loci of this protein we have, the greater the impact on the progression-free survival, and vice versa. The procedure may be performed several times in order to define whether we have to carry on with the therapy or switch to a different one. Second, molecular imaging. It allows us to define not only anatomical structures of the tumor, but also biological and functional changes. Usually a PET and MRI, MRS spectroscopy is used. Monitoring of cellular proliferation, tumors, radiation damages tumor cells, cancer, change of cellular proliferation and apoptosis that may be registered with the help of tracers and PET. This is applicable to lung cancer. On the left, we see dynamic studied tumor proliferation in the process of gamma radiotherapy. Prior to therapy, tumor proliferation is well pronounced, but then it goes down based on that. On the left, we see the strengthening of tumor apoptosis. Hardly today or in the near future we are going to work like this, but maybe in the future the oncologists won't have to think a lot in terms of what to do with potentially resectable 3 year stage patients. Maybe no surgery will be needed at all. Thank you. Your question? The question is out of the mic. Can you describe a patient to whom you would prescribe only gamma radiotherapy? Each one of us certainly prefers a good status patient. 9-100 score on Karnofsky's scale, not always possible. It is considered that the higher the status, the better for the patient. As for the prevalence of the process, starting from stage 3, any stage 3, the patient may, we may start the gamma radiotherapy. For the patient, the lower the volume, the better the result. But based on the tumor volume, nobody compared what is the role of tumor mass in terms of long-term results. But definitely, I would have taken the patient for 3B, maybe 3C stage, if the functional status is suitable, at least the consecutive option, if the patient is weakened. And some patients with 3A, at least those with bulky lymph nodes or multizonal involvement of lymph nodes, registered with the help of all the methods. Any questions more? Maybe not so many surgeons in the room that are interested to operate in case of bulk when we have invasion from lymph nodes. From the point of view of tumor mass, this latest classification is more sensitive depending on the size. T depends on the size of the primary tumor. May I sum up that you would have taken the patient gladly who is functionally operable but who refused the operation? Yes. Okay. Natalia, where exactly are you working in Ulyanovsk? Regional.